gospel according to Matthew, the 15th chapter, verse 21 down to verse number 28. Amen. Matthew, the 15th chapter. Beginning at the 21st verse, we have to say, Amen. And it reads, then Jesus went thence and departed into the coast of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Cana came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with the devil. But he answered her not a word. And the disciples came in and besought him, saying, send her away, for she crieth after us. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Then came she and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered and said, it is not meet to take the children's bread and to cast it to dogs. And she said, truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from thy master's table. Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. And her daughter was made whole from that hour. Word of God for the people of God. Be blessed in the presence of God. Amen. We'll talk, amen, of the subject, her mother's faith. Her mother's faith. Amen. Her mother's faith. Amen. In this biblical text, we find a little girl with a mother. We find this girl being vexed and tormented by the devil. Makes no mention of a praying, and makes no mention of this little girl worshiping. Is only make mention of this little girl being tormented. And thank God for our mother's faith. And a whole lot of us are thank God for our mother's faith. Amen. Because my dad was out working, trying to pay bills. It was mother that was instilling faith in the children. Some dads that flew the coop, ran off and left home, but it was the mother's faith that kept the house together. I wish I had a better church. And we must thank God for mother's faith. It's the reason a whole lot of us are where we are and accomplished what we have is because of mother's faith. One writer said, somebody prayed for me. Somebody else said, my mother prayed for me. And mother's faith has carried us a mighty long way. In the biblical text, Jesus had been on a teaching crusade. He was teaching about impurity. In the midst of his teaching, he had a conversation about the scribes and the Pharisees. He said, these people honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. The disciples, amen, were standing around, amen, and Jesus called the multitude together and said, do you hear and understand what's going on? Now, it's not that which goes in a man that defiles a man, but that which comes out of the man. Here he said, and get a listen, teaching and preaching. Now, the disciples say, knowest thou that the Pharisees got upset at your teaching and at your preaching? Amen. But Jesus answered them, every plant which my heavenly Father has not planted shall be rooted up. Amen. And just leave them alone. There's some folks you just need to leave alone. There's some folks that are just not going to be about God's business. There's some folks you just have to leave them in the hand of the Lord. Amen. Peter and said, tell us, Jesus, you tell us what this parable really means. Yeah. She said, don't you understand it, man? You've been with me long enough to know that it's not what goes in the man that defiles the man, but it's that which comes from the heart that defiles the man. Jesus left Gerasenes, amen, and entered into the coast of Tyre and Sidon. Entering in Tyre and Sidon, the Bible said, behold, take a look, amen, watch this, amen, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David, my daughter is grievously vexed with the devil. This lady, this lady, yeah, amen, Mark would call her in 7:26, I preached it before, would call her a Syrophoenician woman, amen. In the text, it calls her out of the coast of Tyre and Sidon, which means that she was born in the northwest territory of Galilee, which is right now located right near Tyre and Sidon. But Matthew calls her a Canaanite woman because he's writing to a Jewish audience, and the Jews would understand that the Canaanites were the ancestors of the city of Phoenicia, who were enemies to the children of Israel. And isn't it amazing that this lady, being an enemy of God, this lady who really don't know him, and has come to him and say, have mercy on me. A whole lot of us could have turned up our nose at this lady. A whole lot of us could have rolled our eyes at this lady. But the Bible tells us to pray for those who despitefully use you and call you everything but a child of God. You've got to learn how to pray for your enemies. You've got to learn how to forgive your enemies. Because forgiveness is not for the enemy, but forgiveness is for you. A whole lot of us are sitting in the church, missing our blessing and missing our breakthrough, because we're holding malice in our heart. We're holding hatred in our heart. We're holding things in our heart that happened a long time ago. Been so long that somebody asked you, what are you mad about? You really can't remember. Tell your neighbor that something you just gotta let go. Amen.
Amen.
I know the position you have. Yeah. tell your neighbor, the Lord will speak of me. But he answered him and said unto him, I'm not sinned unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And now it seems like even the Lord is against him and will your back heels against the wall and when you don't know what to do, gonna show y'all what she did in the text. The text says that even though all those things was against her, that she came and worshiped him. I wish I had a household that came to worship God. I wish I had some real folk that came to worship him. But even though your bag is against the wall, even though all the odds are against you, you ought to be able to worship him in spirit and in truth. From the Father, the sinking Son, a loose ball, a house dog, yes he is, but She was a Gentile, and even though she was a woman, and even yeah. But I said,